Little bit of snow out there now, first snow of the year. But we're inside, it's warm here inside the barn, and we're taking a look at my guitars. It's funny to be surrounded by them like this. It's like a photo album. I have associations with all of these guitars. My first guitar actually isn't in here. It's missing. It was bought for me when I was 12 years old. I badgered my parents into letting me give up on the cello and start playing guitar. And it was bought from the Schirmer Music Company. It was their sort of store brand guitar, made of laminate, like a plywood guitar, sort of a classical type gut string guitar. But it was good enough to get me started, to start talking to me. My brother Alex eventually hung it up by one of its own strings and spray painted it blue and raised the nut and the bridge to make it into a slide guitar. So I never played it again. But by that time I'd moved on to this guitar, which I bought in it's a Gibson J-50. And I bought it in a music store in Durham, North Carolina, and it was such a step up, such a great guitar. And I wrote my first songs on it, something The Way She Moves, Fire and Rain, Carolina in My Mind. It accompanied me through a decade or so of constantly having it with me and playing on it all the time. And it forgave me a lot of abuse. I left it in the trunk of my car at one point, and the temperature went down to minus 10, and the entire finish of it became cracked and crinkled, but still it sounded great. Until a friend recommended that I amplify it by, I had been sticking these Barkus Berry transducer pickups to the outside of the guitar and amplifying it that way, and he recommended that I install something called hot dots. That they were a way of amplifying an acoustic guitar. It was a sort of dual transducer, and it didn't work. It ruined the guitar until Dave Mirkin, who's behind that camera there, Dave took it to Danny Farrington in Los Angeles, and Danny miraculously returned it to its former glory. I carried this guitar into a room in which Paul McCartney and George Harrison were sitting, willing to listen to me play Something in the Way She Moves. And, you know, so it's got amazing associations for me. It traveled with me halfway around the world. I'm glad that it's still with me.